Thank you. Look, over there, where the wall is broken. Do you see what lies beyond? That's what the land became after the light flooded in. An empty, white nothingness. Life cannot exist in such conditions. The primordial light would wreak havoc on the body's etheric balance. That nectarine you bought. It's Halric's favorite fruit. Most of the patients, Halric included, survived the attacks of powerful eaters. But their fate was sealed all the same. The monster's corruption has entered their bodies, and their very essence is being subsumed by light. The twisted state of the world itself just makes matters worse. Under normal circumstances, a person's ether naturally tends to equilibrium. But for these poor souls, the opposite is true. Sooner or later, every single one of them will turn. Tesline and the patients, they all know this. They know what has to be done before the change goes too far, before the eater within takes over. The preferred method is mixing poison into their favorite food. In my time here, I've borne witness to a lot of last meals. I feel just as helpless as before. No matter how hard I fight, it's never enough. But it's a war I mean to wage, nonetheless. Speaking of wars, do you remember how I made you promise not to leave me and then promptly collapsed? Well, let's just say I had a few choice words for the Exarch concerning the timing of his summons. But even if the fault lay with someone else, I couldn't shake the feeling that I'd abandon you on the battlefield. So I swore that I'd make up for my absence there by making a difference here. And that's what keeps me moving forward, even when things seem hopeless. On which note, it's time we headed back. The longer we keep Tesline waiting, the harder this will be for her.
Speak up if you'd like another helping. I made a little bit more than usual today.
And you've added something special to the broth, if I'm not mistaken.
Aye, well, it's not often we have visitors from the Crystarium, so I may have thrown in a few extra bits and bobs. Oh, it's nothing, really. And we do so rarely have guests. In a place like this, you learn to take what moments of happiness you can get. I remember when I first came here with my mother. She was showing the early signs. I knew there was no way to save her, but I just couldn't face what needed to be done. That's the way of it for most people. Why they travel for moms to stay here. Beaten, broken souls come to wait out the inevitable, to receive the mercy of a painless death. When my mother finally left this world, I was mad with grief, but also thankful that her passing was a peaceful one. It's never easy, ending a life you've cared for, even when you believe they go on to a better place. I often find myself wishing the Warrior of Darkness would come and do that part for me.
The Warrior of Darkness?
You've never heard the tale? I'm not sure where it began, but every child in Norvrent could tell you a version of it. Warrior of Darkness, servant of death, take care of our souls at our dying breath. Let sinners and eaters of sin go with thee, that all may return to the sunless sea. Well, that's the version I was taught anyway. It's just an old bedtime story. He certainly never deigned to visit us here.
Which is a good thing, surely. He sounds rather ominous.
Do you think so? I always liked the idea that he treated every soul the same, even the Sin Eaters.
They're coming.
Tesleen! Have you seen Halric? I swear, I only took my eyes off him for a moment.
Thank you.
sign of him? No luck then. But he surely can't have gone far. We should keep looking. The Sin Eaters are out in force, and if we don't find him soon, you can be sure they will. See the size of that thing? It must be one of the nasty ones. Wherever it's going, it can only mean trouble. After it!
Deserve happiness wherever we can find it. The time left to you is precious. No one should die in vain. Mother, Mother, I...
whistling breeze, mute. The pounding surf, frozen. Time itself takes a breath. At light's edge, all is perfectly still. The world captured in a painting, locked in a moment. Music, faint and fleeting, drifts coastward on the lifeless air. And in the distance, beyond the broken earth, a city beckons.